Hello world! Welcome back to this new video. In the previous video, I talked about the Zeal 8-bit computer emulator, how I implemented it, and how it changed my way of programming for the Z80. If you haven't watched this video yet, I advise you to check it. Today, I would like to show you exactly what this lets us do. Let's get started. By the way, if you want to solder your own Zeal 8-bit computer, the kit is now available on Tindy. I will put a link down below. If you have done some embedded development before, you should be familiar with logic analyzers. These awesome devices let you probe any digital signal at very high frequency. For example, this one can go up to 100 MHz when probing 3 signals. Another advantage of these devices is the number of signals they can probe compared to an oscilloscope. Mine can probe up to 16 signals. Thanks to its accuracy, it's very easy to see what is going wrong on a serial bus such as UART or I2C, or even on a parallel bus. And this is what I used when I wrote the program to interface an SNES controller with Zeal 8-bit computer. More importantly, since the UART signal is generated in software on the Zeal 8-bit computer using the Z80 PIO, the logic analyzer helped me correcting my driver to get perfect timing. The software that comes with it, DSView, can even decode the incoming signal into readable data. So, what is the problem with the logic analyzer? Well, as usual, the problem is the development cycle, or more like the testing cycle. Every time a change is made in the code, I need to compile, take the ROM out, flash it, plug it, power on the board, and trigger the logic analyzer. In fact, we can reduce this testing cycle by a lot thanks to the emulator. How? This is what we are going to see today. The emulator is cycle accurate. This means that when an event occurs on the virtual machine, it knows precisely when it would have happened on the real hardware. In other words, the emulator keeps track of the number of clock cycles each instruction need to be executed. These clock cycles are also named T-states by Zilog. What we want to do now in the emulator is to listen on a particular I/O and register all its change of value. Then, we will store these values in a dedicated file that can be interpreted by a program that will analyze it and generate traces out of it, just like what DSView does with the real logic analyzer. Let's do this. I want to generate a trace file out of the UART TX pin of the 8-bit computer. In the emulator, I implemented this feature in UART.js file. It's JavaScript code, but it should still be fairly easy to understand. In the initialization part of the UART, I invoke the addWire function to the tracer module to specify that I want to listen on that UART TX pin. I am going to name it TX. It returns a handle that I need to give back every time a change occurs on the pin. This is exactly what I do in the function writeTX. The function is called by the Z80 PIO module whenever a write occurs on a pin. The new value is in the variable bit, and transition is true when its value is changing with the new write request. So, if the value of our TX pin changed, we tell the trace dumper about it, giving the handler we got earlier and the new value. The first parameter is the most important. It's the number of clock cycles that have elapsed since the beginning of the virtual machine execution up to the point where the current event occurred. This is what makes the timing so accurate. Okay, we just implemented a way to track the changes on the I/O. What do we do now? How do we get a nice waveform? Well, the easiest and fastest solution is to export these changes into a generic format that can be interpreted by a logic analyzer program. To do so, I'm going to use VCD format, which stands for Value Change Dump. VCD files are text files separated into several parts. The first part are comments, then we have the timescale, used to represent how much time a single clock cycle is. Since the 8-bit computer runs at 10 MHz, let's put this to 100 nanoseconds in our case. Then we name the module and we define wires or signals. Each signal is associated to a single character. We can see them as aliases. Finally, we define all the changes in the form tick number followed by a hash, then a list of new value followed by the alias of the signal. The example you see on screen now defines a signal that goes to 0, then it goes to 1, then to 0, then to 1. So it's a clock signal, and its name or alias is the dollar symbol. To visualize it, I like to use PulseView program because it handles VCD files and protocol decoding. Let's try. Yes, we can see a small clock signal. Perfect. Back to our JavaScript implementation. Inside the tray stomper module, I implemented a function that converts all the changes registered into a VCD file that can be downloaded. We can try it. I'm going to enable the tray stomper from the console and then load Zeal 8-bit bootloader. Since it uses the URTX to output messages, it will be easier to view. It finished printing messages. We are going to execute the download function from the tray stomper module. It's downloaded. Let's import it in pulse view. Looks good. We can try to decode the UART protocol. I set the baud rate to 57,600. And yes, it works. We can see the characters that were printed. It matches what we saw on the console interface. We can compare it to what we get on the real hardware with a logic analyzer. Yes, we have the same output. Looks great. So to conclude, this is very useful for debugging time-sensitive protocols from the emulator directly, saving a lot of time compared to using real hardware. And that's it for today's episode. If you have any question or suggestion, feel free to leave a comment down below, and see you next time.